Gloria in excelsis Deo.
A reading from the Epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Colossians. We give thanks unto the Father, which hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who delivered us out of the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have our redemption, the forgiveness of our sins, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him were all things created, in heaven and upon the earth, things visible and things invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things have been created through him and unto him. And he is before all things, and in him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. For it was the good pleasure of the Father that in him should all the fullness dwell, and through him to reconcile all things unto himself, having made peace through the blood of his cross. Through him, I say, whether things upon the earth or things in the heavens. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Lord be with you. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to John. Then said Pilate unto Jesus, Art thou the King of the Jews? Jesus answered him, Sayest thou this thing of thyself, or did others tell it of thee of me? Pilate answered, Am I a Jew? Thine own nation and the chief priests have delivered thee unto me. What hast thou done? Jesus answered, My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight that I should not be delivered to the Jews, but now is my kingdom not from hence. Pilate therefore said unto him, Art thou a king then? Jesus answered, Thou sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause I came into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth. Everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I had to come the long route, I'm sorry about that. You say that I am king. In the world, with all its alarms, who is in charge? Today, the church makes a bold assertion. Today we celebrate the feast of Christ the King, the end of the Christian year. And so we ask, who is in charge of the world? Christians proclaim, indeed, it is Christ. When the Gospels discuss the kingship of Christ, they do it in a very particular context. The land where Jesus lived was occupied and ruled by the Romans, and the Romans had an emperor whose rule was absolute. Tiberius ruled by force and by fear. Under his rule, Roman citizens lived secure, knowing that no one would dare to attack them. And if they did, there'd be great reprisals. But for subject peoples like the Jews, things were very different. The emperor was their lord and master, and they had better keep quiet and obey him. For anyone else to claim authority was treason of the most dangerous kind and would be punished immediately and severely. And so this is what lies behind Jesus' conversation with Pilate, the Roman governor, running Judea on behalf of Tiberius. If Jesus had indeed claimed to be king, as Pilate had been told, he would be executed immediately. There is room for only one king in the empire. Pilate wants to find out whether Jesus is setting himself up against the emperor, because if he is, that makes Pilate's life very easy. Off with his head. He can just sign the death warrant, get the Jewish leadership off his back, which would give him great joy, and get on with oppressing the people and making even more money out of them. Jesus, however, does not want to talk about that type of kingship. He wants to talk the truth. And it's part of me which understands on the two occasions we do meet Pilate, now and just before the crucifixion, that he is interested in finding the truth, even though he may do nothing about it when he finds it. It's an intellectual need on his part. The account of this conversation, we know, is written long after the events, after the resurrection. We know that Tiberius is dead, but Jesus is alive. Tiberius knows that there is a power here. Jesus knows that there is a power here which has much more claim to the rule of the world than the emperor. The emperor may have power of life and death, but we know that Jesus has power over both, and primarily over death. My kingdom is not of this world. Jesus is the king of a very different kind of kingdom, ruled by peace, not force, by love, not fear. Soon this king will, we know, be fastened to an instrument of execution, which will come to be recognized as his throne for ages to come, as he did indeed rule that day from the cross. Today there are no emperors ruling the world. There's an odd dictator here and there, and I use the word odd advisedly, but they're on a rather smaller scale. Our need is not for them. Our need is for somebody to offer an alternative to the rule of the empire. Our need is for someone to provide security in the chaos. So we ask on this feast of Christ the King, is he indeed the King? We might need to look around us. Does it always seem so? The world appears to be in the grip of financial, political, and national forces completely beyond our control. We ask the question of world survival. Will it be nuclear war that destroys us? Or more likely at the moment, is it global warming? Or the collapse of financial systems? Or, as we're now living in the COVID age, could it indeed be that? It is difficult to find evidence that Christ really is King of the world. So, my good people of St. Michael's, just let's leave the world alone for the time being. Because when we talk of Christ the King, we're talking of evidence. Whatever we feel, we can say that Christ is King. We assert the truth which is deeper than appearances. We reaffirm the truth that at the heart of the universe is a force of peace and justice and love, which is stronger than all human forces, which has been from eternity and will be to the end of time. It is part of human nature to search for meaning in the chaos of life and to want there to be a structure and a purpose. We want to know that someone is in charge. And today we remind ourselves who that is. So I said a moment ago about leaving the world behind, because the way to look at Christ the King is to see him in my heart and your heart, in my home and in your home, in your friendships, my friendships, together. If he can reign in those situations in which we find ourselves, then he is indeed King. So, good people of St. Michael's, and could I say, on this great feast, it is indeed good to be back here together. It's been a long time since we've had an orchestral mass, and I thank you all, orchestra, choir, Dion, etc., for bringing the end of the Christian world to a right good grand send-off, as we say in Yorkshire. And be blessed in knowing that Christ is indeed the King who reigns in our hearts and takes charge of every word and every deed. And may you indeed be blessed in the path of the King. Amen.
Almighty God, who has taught us to pray for all men and has promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in faith, we beseech thee to look mercifully upon thy universal church and to inspire it with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. We pray especially for the work of the church in this diocese and ask thy blessing on Tabo, our bishop, and Joshua, his suffragan. Lord, in thy mercy. We pray for the needs of those who live in this place and worship in this church. Most high God, majestic and mighty, our beginning and our end, rule in our hearts and guide us to be faithful, worshipping the one who comes as Saviour and Sovereign, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Spirit, one God, now and forever. We pray for a right stewardship of the world thou hast created. We pray for the nations of the world and for their leaders, that they may minister justice for the maintenance of righteousness and peace. At this time, we pray for refugees all around the world, trying to escape oppression, poverty, persecution, violence, and war. Especially at this time, we pray for those hemmed in under deplorable and freezing conditions on the Polish-Belarusian border. Like your disciples, we too are filled with fear and doubt and even suspicion. We build barriers in our hearts and in our minds. We ask that you will assist us to find compassion and generosity of spirit towards our fellows who are seeking a new and better life elsewhere. We pray for those elected to public office, both in our own land and throughout our continent, as we say, God bless Africa. Guard her children, guide her leaders, and give her peace. For Jesus Christ's sake, amen. We beseech thee to bless both those whom we love and those for whom we are bound to pray. Lord, in thy mercy. We beseech thy goodness to send thy healing grace to all who suffer in body or in soul. Especially we pray for Archbishop Desmond Tutu, Leah Tutu, Jackson Nettlebeck, Matthew Hickmott, Lucy Morgas, Lisa McBride, David Glendinning, Chris Woolnough, Valerie Atkinson, Patrick and Ray Wilton, Timothy McBride, Cecil Tace, Liana R. Singh, Lister Nuku, Marlene Sharp, Kate Taylor, Jean Bataro, Brother Michael, OGS, Lyndall van der Velt, Douglas Pettit, Layla Adams, and Chloe Rolfs. Lord, in thy mercy. We commend to thy gracious keeping all those who've died in faith. Especially we pray for those whose years mine fall this week. Charles Sala, Anna Parsons, June Perkins, Charles Foster, Mabel Hartwig, Derek Crawford, Dickie Capstick Dale, William Kahnemeyer, Kathleen Murphy, Michelle Rankmore, William Barron, priest, Hilda Jeremy, William Walker, Winifred Middlecote, and John Girdwood. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let life perpetual shine upon them. We pray for those who will die in our city today, especially those who will die alone and unloved. Lord, in thy mercy. As we prepare to celebrate the mystery of Christ's love, let us acknowledge our failures and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. We confess.
God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed through our own grievous fault. Wherefore we pray God to have mercy.
The kings of Arabia and Saba shall bring peace. All kings shall fall down before it. All nations shall do him
service.
very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, who with thine only Son and the Holy Ghost art one God, one Lord in Trinity of persons and in unity of substance, who has created all things through thy eternal word. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, who in the same night that he was, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks to them, saying, drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me.
Thank you.
by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. As our Savior Jesus Christ hath commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with us.
Thank you. not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. with you. Christ, our exalted King, pour upon you his abundant gifts and bring you to reign with him in glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
That we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. We beseech thee, O Lord, pour thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.